see the sky lately. Those wicked white lines, they're poison.
American Freedom Radio Network proudly presents, live from Phoenix, Arizona, the Truth Denied Talk Radio with host Roxy Lopez. Join us here for topics you won't hear on mainstream news, such as chemtrails, GMOs, Morgellons disease, and much more. Humanity is 7 billion strong. We are the majority. And now, live from the Valley of the Sun, your host, Roxy Lopez.
It is July 13th. Murdering us from the sky. He's up next. Please give him our attention. He's a wonderful man. We'll be right back. July 13th, an interesting thing. You know, a lot of you have been posting about the threes, the number three. And I think it's interesting, too. And just for everybody's sake, we will be continuing to cover this. This is just the beginning of what's going to be going on down there. So we're going to continue it. Now, look, I'm really excited about something else as well. JEFF SAXON, who is on the homepage, you can see his video of Murdering Us from the Sky. That's on the homepage of thetruthdenied.com. That's thetruthdenied.com. And for some of you who are listening to the show, you probably can't play the video at the same time you're listening to the show, so I wouldn't try to do that, but you can listen to it later. But we're going to try to play some stuff here today that JEFF is doing. JEFF is a wonderful man. Spent a few hours on the phone with him, and you know, I just want to give a warm welcome to a lovely man. And of course, I am a musician as well, so we kind of have a bond from hello. JEFF SAXON, I want to welcome you to the Truth Tonight Talk Radio. How are you?
Oh, thanks so much, Roxy. I'm good. How are you? Can you hear me?
I can. I can hear you really.
Wow.
Yeah, you're good.
I feel like I'm in an episode of The Jetsons already. I've done iChat, but I've never done the Skype on a radio show. So I'm really pleased to be here. Thanks for having me and for all the nice words.
Oh, you're totally welcome. You know, I guess what I'd have to ask you first of all, you know, and I do find it interesting. I find it interesting that a lot of my fellow musicians, you know, you and I talked about this on the phone. You know, we really were born to think outside the box.
Oh yeah.
And I think you can agree. I was going to say, I think you can agree.
How far out can we go?
Yeah, and we don't tend to, you know, function in the world of society very well. For instance, we're not good at holding a 9-to-5 jobs. I mean, we have a lot in common when it comes to that. And I think the audience can try to remember back to a time maybe too where 9-to-5 didn't work. You know, there's actually people out there that really like 9-to-5 and they like a paycheck every single week and so forth and so forth. And for you and I, we find that to be real limiting for our life.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, it's important for a lot of people to, you know, to go on the straight and narrow like that. And, you know, on a lot of levels, it's, you know, you can kind of breathe a sigh of relief if you have that stability. But it's also a great endeavor to go outside the box, like you said, and let your creative, you know, instincts lead you on on different trails every given day, every given week.
Absolutely. And that's what you just said something so important. Do you think that everyone's creative?
I think everyone has the potential to be creative in their own way. I think it really depends on the channeling of that creativity and how you can kind of get in touch with it and seize it and model it, you know, mold it into something tangible, like a song, a book, a piece of visual art. So I do think everybody has a creative side, some more than others, obviously, but I think the key is knowing what to do with it.
Right. That's a really good point. And when did you discover, first of all, what instruments do you play and do you write all the material? And then we're going to get into your material because I have to tell you, I wasn't expecting Murdering Us from the Sky. I wasn't expecting it to be what it was. And I told you this on the phone and I mean this, I'm not just saying this live on the air. From the first note, I got shivers up and down my spine. It touched, and we can talk about that a little bit later, how music is really very we all need music just as much as we need food and love and all the rest of it.
Yeah, it really –
right?
Maybe not in that order, but
– Right, right. Well, the tones, I mean, I think we all – you know, Deborah, who was down at Bohemian Grove the first hour here, you know, she was talking about how they're targeting us and really throwing all these, you know, crazy frequencies at us right now, you know, RF and radiation and cell towers and on and smart meters that aren't smart at all and all the rest of it and the grids. And, you know, music is that's what I mean about how much we need music, because the frequency of music is soothing and it causes us to reflect and it causes us to remember who we are. And these you know, Deborah Tavares has a point. These other frequencies that they're bombarding with us, you know, bombarding us with, I should say, are killing us.
And it's all uncharted. It's all new stuff, and you know there's no real data on it yet because it is so new. But you can just tell in your gut that you know these things are not good things. These are not positive things that are going to be a boon to anybody's health and well-being and quality of life. So there's more stuff going on now than ever before in my lifetime, and that's really kind of what spurs me on to write songs like Murdering Us from the Sky and some of my other topical material, is that I feel I have to, my first purpose is not necessarily to educate, but it's to engage people and say, look, hey, check this out. This is not good. We need to kind of rally together and try to, you know, turn this thing back, like the, you know, chemtrails and, you know, and everything else. It just seems to be more and more inundation of stuff, of roadblocks, of just things that are impeding the quality of life. And so as a songwriter, I just feel I have to, you know, oftentimes speak out like this in song and make videos to correspond with them.
Absolutely. And, you know, the public really appreciates you. I know I do.
Oh, thank you.
Absolutely, because your work is healing. Your work gives people I've heard a lot of feedback about your work, and the general public really appreciates you, especially.
Well, that's good to know.
Yeah, of course, especially the geoengineering chemtrail activists. They really, really appreciate your work, which brings me to what influenced Murdering Us from the Sky. I mean, it's obvious, but tell us what influenced you
to
write that beautiful song, by the way.
Well, thank you again. Well, ironically enough, I was driving home one day. I live here in New Jersey, and I was driving home, ironically, from a Green Party event. You know, Green Party, the environment, and I'm driving home late afternoon, beautiful day, sunny. I look up in the sky, and it was just things going on. You know, up in the sky, it was like some bizarre kamikaze tic-tac-toe game going on up there, and I've never seen anything like it, and it was not a demonstration or a show. It was just some, you know, these sustained puffy markings, these plumes, and I was just riveted to it, and I could not assign it to anything in my lifetime that I've seen. And it just, the word that came to my mind, and I never thought this way, is malevolent. They just seemed like it was evil. And I mentioned it to, you know, I get home and I was just transfixed with these images of the sky, and I told my wife about it, and she actually knew about these chemtrails, and at that point on, I just went on an extended research period of, you know, looking into chemtrails and geoengineering, and the more I learned, the more revolted and angry I became, and I finally said, you know what, absolutely have to write a song about this. And then I set that into motion, wrote the song, and worked with a producer friend of mine in California, and we did some file sharing. I recorded some basic tracks here and sent those to him, and he did a marvelous job doing the rest of the production. And his name is Michael McGregor. And he and I have worked together, you know, on and off for years with my, you know, producing my songs of all styles, all, you know, all genres. And it just clicks. And so from that point on, I knew I had to do a music video. It was just kind of calling out for that to get some of the images of chemtrails and the facts about them, or at least the things that a lot of people have accepted to be the facts, and then some speculations as well, and put that together, put that out, got it on YouTube, and it just kind of engaged people from there, and on it went. You had asked me about what instruments, and I'm primarily a guitarist and a singer. And, you know, and first and foremost, a songwriter. I've dabbled here and there on other instruments, but, so what you hear in my tracks is my guitar work and vocals and background vocals and so forth. But Murdering Us from the Sky just kind of summoned me that it needed to get out there. There was really nothing else out there that I could find that had a strong enough statement behind it.
Right. And I love what you did with the song, because you, like I said, you really get to the heart of the matter, literally. The song is very touching, Jeff, and I can appreciate that, you know. Let's see, maybe we've got, do you have, can you maybe play us some of Murdering Us from the Sky?
I'm gonna go into my iTunes library, and I'm gonna attempt that.
Okay, we'll see if it works. Hey, trial and error. We'll see if it works. Yeah, that'll be great. Let us know when you're going to start.
I'm gonna click it right now. All right.
Okay, great.
Here we go.
Okay. Not hearing anything.
No.
No. Can you hear anything?
I can. Yeah. Can you hear it now?
No, we can't hear anything.
Okay. Okay. All right.
So,
I sent it. You know, I sent it off to you, you know, earlier. So I don't know what to say. You know,
I'm in the same boat. I have iTunes as well, and I'm in the same boat. And unfortunately, today, American Freedom Radio, they're under the gun as well. They just had an outage for a couple of days when they couple hours here and there from their storm in Texas. So they're kind of just patching everything together and unable to play the material, which only means, Jeff, one thing. That you and I get that worked out another time, and then we'll play, like, you know, four or five of your songs.
Okay,
and if you'll come back and do that, so there's that, and then the other thing is, where can people listen to some of the material? Because that's a song I know that they can on my website.
Yeah,
but where are other websites? You've got a website that they can listen to the material as well.
It's, I have a website for, you know, specifically for the song murderingusfromthesky.com, and the song, the video is up there, so they could hear the song, see the video there. And it's also it can be previewed and purchased on iTunes and CD Baby. You know, we get to hear about a minute and three quarters of it, I believe, and you know, get a real taste for what it's like. And you know, those are the some of the choices. My website is jeffsaxonmusic.com, and I have links to everything related to the song there too. So that would be an easy way for people to hear the song and see the video.
Right, and I love the video for Murdering Us from the Sky. I think that's just awesome. Just an awesome.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's awesome. Well, it's to the bone real, you know. That's all I can say, you know. I don't know if you want to do this, but I'm really into that song. Do you want to do any By the way, I just put the MP3 in the Skype window, but I don't think we can do anything with it. No. I just thought maybe there would be another way that we could play it, but we can't do it either. And like I said, I'm in the same boat with you. I'm on iTunes. And so when you're playing it in iTunes, you're not hearing anything on your iTunes, huh?
Oh, I am. I'm hearing it in my phones, yeah.
You are, and we're not hearing it. You know what? It's something to do with the station then. It's not coming through. Yeah. I figured out there's a program, and so let's move on. We'll move on. Yeah. We'll make it happen. We'll make it happen the next show. It's no big deal. Some of the lyrics.
Mm-hmm.
Can you read us some of the lyrics? Would you mind terribly reading us some of the lyrics from Murdering Us from the Sky? Does that sound dorky?
No. I mean, really, and who can define dorky at this point? Have you seen the sky lately? Those wicked white lines? They're dropping poison down on you and I. These devious deeds will sadly proceed until we all demand an answer why they're murdering us from the sky. It's time to stop the madness and end this evil crime of murdering us from the sky. If we don't, we'll die. In the bright light of day, they brazenly spray these chemtrails into the atmosphere that bring disease and distress. It's a toxic game of chess that they play without a bit of guilt or fear. They're murdering us from the sky. It's time to stop the madness and end this evil crime of murdering us from the sky. If we don't, we'll die. Sure, there's lots of other things I'd rather think about or do, but it's hard to with what's going on above. And if you feel like me, that it's a human tragedy, let the ones in power know you've had enough of this murdering us from the sky.
That's beautiful. And thank you for reading that. You know,
you're welcome.
I think you raise a really amazing emotion. Isn't it interesting? Because you say in the song, you know, that you'd rather be thinking about other things, but this is such a distraction, this stuff going on in the skies. You know, it's quite interesting because there are so many people that don't even notice what's going on in the skies.
Right.
Why do you think that is?
I think they're just locked into their little realities. And I mean, I don't mean it little in a condescending way. I mean little in a, like, what's more urgent to you, you know, getting food on the table, making sure your family is okay, getting to your destinations, getting to work, getting to school, et cetera. And the other thing, which is what I've come to call the third appendage, you know, all the, you know, the phones, the texting, everybody is locked into something extending from their arm instead of looking up above their arms into the sky. So I think there's a combination of events that have, you know, it was an old movie years ago, My Private Idaho. They're in their own private Idaho.
Right, exactly. That makes total sense. That makes absolute sense. And with that in mind, what about when we show people? Have you ever done that? Have you ever encountered an individual who you are watching the grids being made in the sky and you're trying to show them and explain it to them? Have you ever had that? And can you tell us what happens to you when that happens? What do they do? Do they believe you or do they think you're not?
Well, a lot of people think they just attach it to regular, you know, jet plumes, you know, commercial jet contrails. And that's not the case. You know, we're going to break, I guess.
Wait, we'll talk more about that when we come back from our break. We're speaking with Jeff Saxon, his hit song, Murdering Us from the Sky. You're listening to The Truth Tonight Talk Radio. Don't go anywhere. I love talking to fellow musicians. You totally get what I mean. You know, and speaking of, you know, the music end of this, Jeff, and again, you know, major kudos to you, dude, because, you know, you've taken it to another level. You've taken your career to yet another level and to be able to speak out. And I know as well as you do, you know, when you play live, sell CDs, this and that, this becomes the way in which you reach out to people. And it's a positive effort that you're doing because we all have the complaints of what's happening to us, as we heard from our early, you know, the first hour of the show live from Bohemian Grove. We know what we the people are slowly catching on, but we are catching on to the fact that we're maybe possibly in an end game scenario here with being not only targeted but controlled. Our food, our air, and our water, which you're very well versed in. And so with that in mind, when you're speaking with people, we were talking about that before the break, you know, and trying to explain to somebody about a jet contrail versus an artificial cloud formation, which a lot of people are getting accustomed to that. They're now being able to visually see the difference. And I just want to interject real quick. You know, we've never been able to find the planes that are doing this, but I have to say this. Something spectacular and just mind-blowing happened this past weekend in Arizona. I got to view six military gigantic planes in military formation, a V military formation, spraying chemtrails from horizon to horizon in the military jet path. Their flight path. That's the first time, and as you well know, I've been filming jets in the sky for now 3 years. That is the first time I ever had confirmation that it's the military. It's the first time I've ever had confirmation. About 2 hours after that happened, by the way, I was not able to photograph it. Both cameras would not photograph them. The first time, the cameras wouldn't even turn on. And then the second time, I saw three of them in formation doing the exact same thing. And by the way, those did turn into artificial clouds. They did spread out and come and become artificial clouds. Yeah. The second time around, I shot it again. All I got was the trail. The chemtrail, the contrail, whatever anybody wants to call that, and I did not get the planes. The planes would not come into it was blank. All the plane shots were completely blank, and I did that with two separate cameras that I know very well. So I think that's really interesting that I couldn't nab. Because, see, if I would have gotten the photo of that formation, that's undeniable proof that the military's doing it.
Wow, that sounds like a Twilight Zone episode.
Isn't it?
That's really... it's eerie. It's you know, besides eerie. What they were doing, I mean, the fact that you tried to take a picture of it and you know, you came up empty.
Oh, yeah. And you know, I don't really care if people believe me or not. You know, it's not one of those things.
Well, I mean, why would you want to, you know, why would you say, I mean, why would you come up with a specific story? It's like,
well,
you know.
I never in a million years, because don't forget, what I film is one plane at a time, because that's all they ever are, is one plane. I mean, it might be 40 planes in a day, but they're one at a time or flying way, way far apart. They're not flying in formation in a military jet. Formation. So when I saw this, I you know, for a split second, Jeff, I couldn't believe what I was seeing. That's I kid you not. I just looked at it, and then I followed the trail all the way down to the horizon, and then watched them continue to go to the you know, from, they were going from south to north. North to south, and I looked at it, and the first thing I did is ran in and grabbed the cameras, because I couldn't believe I was actually viewing this in the last 3 years. And anybody that has ever seen this, I want you to call in the show today, because I'm trying to find anybody that has seen this before, has seen military jets in formation now, several jets at one time, with each of them spraying like four plumes. So you can imagine how huge this looked.
Now, how were they marked? I mean, how did you attach military to them?
Because they were in military formation. When's the last you saw, you know, Alaska Airlines, six of them in V-shape?
Right. Wow.
That's how you know. You know, we do have a caller that's been waiting on the line. I just checked the caller lines. I've been so interested in what you're having to say. Let's take a caller. You mind?
Sure. Let's do it.
Okay, great. So let's see. We have a caller, Tim, in Washington, D.C. Welcome to the Truth Denied Talk Radio. We're speaking with JEFF SAXON, the musician who wrote Murder.
How you doing, man?
Hi. Welcome,
Tim.
Hi. Yeah, I call all the time. There's other couple of hosts I always be calling all the time. So this is the first time I've called your show. I've been sending stuff on your Facebook page. I sent you something about, I mentioned something about chemtrails. I put the go ahead, 9 day call a conspiracy. I kind of put that on your Facebook page. If you see it, that's my name. Couple of things. I'm a musician, and I understand you said you're a musician. Have you ever, Roxy, have you ever thought, like, when they, you know, when they play some of the songs, the intro, you ever putting some of your stuff on there?
You know, thank you for saying
Tim should be your agent.
Yeah, really. Let's talk after the show. You know, that's interesting. Many people have asked me to do that, and a lot of the listeners have actually found the albums online and purchased them. And I don't promote that. As a matter of fact, the first year of my activism, I didn't even tell anybody that I was a major label recording artist, because I didn't want anybody to become like, I'll be really straight with you guys, I didn't want anybody to know that about me, so they didn't become groupies, mm-hmm. as opposed to the activism that I stand behind. And so I didn't really let anybody know about that. The other thing is, and Jeff can account for this, and any guest that's ever been on my show, Tim, in answer to your question, I promote my guests. That's what I promote. I promote my guests, what they're selling, what they're offering, whether it be music, art, jewelry, psychic readings, books, documentaries. I promote my artists and everyone that is a guest on the show. So I sort of leave myself out of that mix, but I really appreciate the thought.
Right. Okay, now what I really want to talk about now, I talk about chemtrails all the time. And sometimes I take pictures. I live near the D.C. area, Maryland, and I'm telling you, I go out in the morning, like 7 o'clock, and I'm seeing them spraying already. And I pull out my camera from time to time, and I do take pictures. And the skies, for the last few days, the skies have been looking awful. I mean, it's
what part of the country are you in? You're in Washington, D.C.
Yes. The skies look awful. I mean, it looks like a fake artificial sky. I mean, I tell people all the time, I got people who don't believe me. I go through the naysayers I put up with all the time. Sometimes if I bring the subject up now, people will sit there and scoff at me. And I'm like, man, research it. I'm always constantly telling people, research it. I posted something. Somebody had a rebuttal about the chemtrail. They were saying that the chemtrails are contrails. They try to give me the Wikipedia's version. I'm like, no, I'm not falling for that, because the contrails don't leave the skies this crazy looking. I mean, I said, we all have eyes. We're not stupid. So I'm constantly still putting the word out, and I appreciate my man putting the song out. I hope they copy that. That's cool, because I mean, I want to write something about chemtrails and other things.
Well, write a song about chemtrails, and we'll put it on the website, Tim.
Okay. And one more thing I have to say, I don't want to monopolize this, but I know you got a show. They were talking about the Obamacare and the health care bill. And I'm telling people who have discussions, I said, you can't bring that up. You have to bring in all of the elements that regards our health, like the chemtrails, the Monsanto's, the Food and Drug Administration. All these people are in cahoots because it affects our health. The fluoride in the water. So if you're sick, you got to look at what's making you sick.
Right, right. And I so appreciate your call, Tim. You sound like you're very aware of what's happening, and I'm sure that you'll be very effective in your world with what's happening in the world. You know, I really appreciate your call. Anything that you wanted to say, Jeff?
No, I'm glad. I'm glad, you know, he's really observant to that degree, and he's spreading the word. I mean, that's what it's going to take, a grassroots effort. People convincing other people that they need to look around, see what's going on, and write their politicians, and you know, contact them and try to get this, you know, this madness stopped. So good work on your part, Tim.
Okay, I'm gonna go now. I'm gonna let y'all finish the show. But if I get any pictures of the sky, I'm gonna send them to your Facebook page.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much, Tim. Thanks for calling the show.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Sure. And that was Tim from Washington, D.C. So, you see, we really are doing something, aren't we, Jeff?
Mm-hmm.
We really, you know, one by one, you know, he said something very important. Mm-hmm. He said that he looks up in the sky and can tell the difference all the crap in the air.
Yeah, he used the phrase artificial looking sky.
That's right.
And
yeah.
It is. It's not the same sky that we once knew. certainly not the sky we knew when we were growing up. So, you know, and then the fact that, you know, many less days of sun and, you know, weird weather going on. And then, you know, and he also touched upon another good point about, you know, people getting sick. And that's another thing in my research that, you know, and just common sense, really, if you compare the amount of sickness and the amount of, like, you know, autoimmune stuff going, you know, that people are beset with, and the increased number of you know, babies that are, you know, born with defects, and there's so many different things that are adversely affected. The increase of Alzheimer's, you know, all stuff when we were kids, these kind of, you know, Epstein-Barr, all these diseases, or at least this ratcheting up of different types of diseases and numbers of them, that wasn't going on years ago, 10, 20, you know, 30 years ago, it wasn't going on. And it's just getting more and more prevalent, and people are getting sicker. I know that, Russ Tanner of the Global Skywatch website, he, who's been a champion of my work from the beginning, and he says chemtrails, you know, has ruined his life. I mean, it's just made him sick, and he's got a laundry list of things, you know, wrong with him medically. And so this wasn't on, you know, this wasn't going on to the degree, you know, it years ago as it is now. So. He's right, Tim, the caller, about, you know, you gotta look at the big picture, you know, not only, you know, the environmental damage, but, you know, what's going on with our health as a result of what, you know, what's going on in the sky.
Right. Right. Well, and, you know, we've interviewed Russ a few times, mm-hmm. We're friends with Russ Tanner, and, you know, you're absolutely right. He had a plethora. He even said that one day when they were spraying for days or on end, that he ended up in emergency. Now, this is a really healthy guy, by the way.
Yeah, I've seen a couple pictures of him. I mean, he looks, you know, like a normal, healthy guy.
Right, right.
But, I mean, it's on the surface.
Well, he is. And you know, and he takes good care of himself and so forth and so forth. But here's the deal. He also ended up in emergency because he was having symptoms of a heart attack. And so when he came on the show, he actually explained to us what that symptom is like a sharp pain in his heart. He thought he was having a heart attack.
Wow.
And since that show, we've had many people write in as well, Jeff, about that, like people having that symptom, myself included, on heavy chemtrail spraying day. And he basically said, so you're right, the idea of many, many different ailments, illnesses that are going on that are associated with a number of things, not just chemtrails, but chemtrails being the additive. And then what about the security, you know, of the planet as well? I mean, the HARP that's in conjunction with the food companies like Monsanto. And why would Monsanto make a resistant seed, an aluminum resistant seed? Why?
Yeah, well, maybe it's because there's a whole lot of aluminum in chemtrails, you know, and other goodies that they put in.
I know, but you can't prove that.
No,
Jeff.
No, I can't. You can't. We can't.
No, the fact of the matter is we can. It's through soil samples and rain samples. Of course, we can prove it. Yeah. It's through soil samples and rain samples. I was giving you a hard time, but even that evidence is not being stepped up in courts of law. And we can talk a little bit more about that when we get back from this break. You're listening to Jeff Saxon, Murdering Us from the Sky is the hit song, and he's got a lot to say. We're live with Jeff Saxon on the Truth Denied Talk Radio. And Jeff, you and I were talking about during the break, which I think is so amazing, but I'm going to just be quiet and let you tell about this World Music and Independent Film Festival in Washington, D.C. Tell us about this and the song that you entered and got accepted and all of it. Want to hear about that?
I guess this goes into the category of this just in, you know, I just found out this afternoon about this, another song, in this case, a, you know, a political oriented song of mine called High Time for a Hero which was made into a wonderful video with a very talented director by the name of Christina Eliopoulos. And she assembled a cast of casting crew of about 25 people, including dancers from the Joffrey Ballet and Alvin Ailey and some amazingly talented photographers. And we made this video last summer and submitting it to film festivals. And I just found out this afternoon it's an official selection of the World Music and Independent Film Festival in D.C. coming up next month in the categories of Best Rock Music Video. And this is a song that I wrote just looking at the political times that we're in, and the world needs a hero. The United States needs a hero, and I'll dangle that statement out there. And it's a song of yearning. It's a song of but also hope, and just an urgent plea for, you know, the things that are going wrong to be righted out, to be, you know, to be addressed by, you know, people who can make a difference. So, right. So the song is, it's not an attack song. It's not a, you know, it's a nonpartisan political outcry of, you know, hey, we need a giant Band-Aid for a lot of things that are going wrong in this country. I mean, we wouldn't have the Occupy movement. We wouldn't have protests throughout the world for a number of different reasons if things were all, peaches and cream. So people are voicing their discontent, and they want change. And this is a song that, again, was inspired by my gut feel of where things are headed, and I want to see them headed in a better direction. And I sang that song at an Occupy event in D.C., just a matter of blocks from the Capitol, about 5-6 months back, and that was a chilling experience. The video is up on YouTube. The song is out there on iTunes and so forth. So people can check it out. I wish we could hear it tonight, but maybe that'll be for the next time.
Oh yeah, totally. When are you going to be at this World Music and Indie Film Festival in Washington, D.C.?
That's coming up toward the end of August. August 25th is the. I'm just getting, like, you know, little bits and pieces this afternoon about it. I requested more details about it, but it's the awards and the gala event is going to be on August 25th.
Okay, make sure, you know, we'll definitely stay tight on this, because as soon as you get any advertisement for it, I'll put that up on the Truth Tonight website. Yeah, absolutely. We've got your stuff up there too, and, you know, people definitely, you know, they find their way to you, and that's good. I mean, that's why we provide the service to everybody, to all our guests. We just provide the service.
You've been great. You know, you've been a great supporter of mine, and I really appreciate what you've done, and, you know, the promotion that you've given me. And that's what it takes. It takes shows like yours and people, you know, who are just impassioned about making a positive change in the world. So, and putting people on that are, you know, are doing those kind of activities. So,
well, you know, thank you for saying that. Absolutely. Thanks for saying that. The whole thing is encouraging. I think you're doing it. I think we're all doing it. Anybody that's related to the show, the American Freedom Radio Network is doing it to provide platforms. And, you know, kudos, shout out to American Freedom Radio for allowing me to have a show here as well. Because otherwise, I wouldn't have be able to take my, you know, voice to the next level of reaching people. So we're very appreciative of that as well. People who listen to the shows, and I want to say this to the listening audience, every one of us has a task in this, and every one of us can get involved. And it doesn't take, it's not any genius. Everyone here knows a little something. Some people are good at writing paragraphs. Some people are good at blog sites. Some people are actually good at, you know, making websites. Some people are good at just, you know, taking flyers and going out into the street with them. Or someone like you, Jeff, who took your musical career and said, you know what, I'm going to use this as my vehicle now.
Well, you know, sometimes you have to do it. I mean, you know, it's pretty heavy, you know, emotional, you know, experience to these are not, everything is happy and, you know, the world is perfect right now. But there's songs that speak of the times that we're in, and I think really resonate with the responses that I've gotten. People really, you know, click with the messages in the songs. So it tells me that I'm on the right track, and it kind of gives me affirmation to do these kinds of songs again. But it does get heavy. In fact, you know, I've been writing a couple of those happier songs of late, just to kind of get the little, you know, to get more of a balance going, so that I, you know, I mean, I think there's inspiration in all songs, but I think you need to have a little bit of balance and some fun too, and that's what I try to do as a writer and as an artist, you know, not to be too bleak but to not mince any words. It's always been my mantra, so to speak. You know, my third album is called Truth Teller, so I think that really is emblematic of what I'm about with whatever I do.
That's awesome. And, and I like the idea that you're talking about that balance, because a lot of people really are, you know, a lot of activists even, they're imbalanced, you know, they're just absorbing all this dark stuff, you know, going down
these rabbit holes. It penetrates your soul, yeah.
It does. And when you said, you know, thank you for saying that too, the heaviness, because you're absolutely right. There is a heaviness that comes with this. And we shouldn't be just doing the dark, heavy stuff, because it's going to make us succumb to it, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
Like, get us depressed, right? I'm sure you've been there.
Yep.
So I know I have on occasion. Jeff, what's your website again, where people can go to just see all about what you're doing?
My website is jeffsaxonmusic.com, and the other website that I mentioned, it was murderingusfromthesky.com. Mm-hmm. And you know, everything that they, you know, everything and maybe too much.
Have you seen the sky lately? Those wicked white lines, they're poison and they fall on you and I. These devious deeds will sadly proceed until we all demand an answer. It's a toxic